I've a little bit of flu, but it is disturbing me. But by the grace of God, everything is well.
Amen.
Can you move a little bit closer to the front of you? What is like one chair for two people, one chair for one? Can you just maybe move forward a little bit so that you can do? God is good. We thank God for this morning, for it is Him who has given us every opportunity that we have. We thank Him for His goodness. We are going to start our lesson as we usually used to. What is the title for this podcast? Okay. Okay, we'll start with our memory verse. Yes, that's it. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Let's start with our memory verse. Do we have other languages here? Yes, my brother, French.
Béni soit le Dieu. Le Père de notre Seigneur Jésus-Christ, le Père des miséricordes, le Dieu de toute consolation. 2 Corinthiens chapitre 1, verset 3.
Amen. Yes, do you have another language? Yes, Mr. Jutai. Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. So next year, I'm also praying that I'll be also reciting it in Yoruba. May God help me. So, okay, I think, do we have another language again? Then we can move to English. Who have learned it in English? Yes, my sister.
Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the Lord of all comfort. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 3.
Amen. Okay, can we say it all of us to the count of three? 1, 2, 3.
Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercy and the Lord of all comfort.
Amen. May God be blessed.
Amen.
So, what is the topic of our lesson of today? Yes, my sister.
Comfort.
Can we say it all of us?
Comfort.
Very good. We thank God for His goodness. And where do we find our text of today? Bible text. Yes, brother.
Genesis chapter 26.
Okay. And the other one? Is there somebody who knows? Okay, then we can go to the text. Let's open quickly to Genesis chapter 28.
Genesis chapter 28, verse 10. Yes. And the Jacob went out from Beersheba and went toward Haran. And then he lighted up upon his sacrifice and carried the altar because then The sun was set, and he threw all the stones of the darkness and put them before his pillows, and lay down in that place to be God. And he dreamt, and behold, had that settled upon the heart, and the top of him, and the top of his wishes to come, and behold, the goodness of God ascending and descending on it, 13. And he looked, and the Lord stood above it, and said, I am the Lord God of Abraham, the Father, and the God of Isaac, the Lamb, we are come without lens, to be like him it, and to receive 14. And thy seed shall as the first of the and thou shalt spread abroad. To the west, and to the east, and to the north, and to the south. And in thee, and in thy seed shall all the families of the earth be blessed. And behold, I am with thee, I will keep thee in all places with thou thou blessed. And I will bring thee again into this land, for I will not leave thee, but I have done that which hath proven.
Amen. Can we have somebody else to continue from verse 16? Who have opened? Yes, Mama.
Verse 26. Verse 26. He came up the great tablet out of his feet, and he said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I know it. And I knew it not. 17. And he was afraid and said, how dreadful is this place? This is not another but the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. 18. The king of those had been in the morning, and took a stone and had put for his head, and set it up for the pillar, and poured bread upon the top of it. 19. And he called the name of that place Bethel, but the name of that city was called Jerusalem at the first.
Amen. Can I have somebody again to open in chapter 32? We are going to do verses 24 to 30. And somebody has to open chapter 33. We are going to read from verse 1 to 4.
And Jacob was left alone, and then wrestled the man with him until the break of the day. 25. And when he saw that the male put against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh, and the hollow of Jacob's eye was about to join as he wrestled him. 26. And he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. And he said, I will not let thee go except thou bless me. 27. And he said unto him, what is thy name? And he said, Jacob. 28. And he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel. For as a prince hast thou power with God and with men, shall pass with them. 29. And Jacob asked him and said, tell me, I pray to thy name. And he said, wherefore is it that thou hast asked after my name? And he blessed him there. 30. And Jacob called the name of the place Peniel, for I have seen God face to face in my life.
Amen. Chapter 33, verses 1 to 4.
And Jacob lifted up his eye and looked, and behold, a full camp with him 400 men. And he divided the children unto Leah and unto Rachel and unto two men, handmaids, two. And he put the handmaids and their children foremost, and Leah and the children after, and Rachel and Joseph kindermost. 3. And he passed over before them and bowed himself to the ground 7 times. And he came near to his brother. 4. And Esau ran to meet him and embraced him and fell on his neck and kissed him and they went.
Amen. May the name of the Lord be praised.
Amen.
We thank God for his goodness. As we have read in our lesson, we have seen that we have read the different types of issues that have happened in the history of the Bible. And we thank God that we are learning about them today for our own strength and also for our own comfort when we believe in the Lord that he will do as he promised in his word. So now, as we have said, as I'm asking about the topic of the lesson of our day, we say that we are going to talk about comfort. When you hear the word comfort, how can you describe comfort? Yes, brother.
Comfort can simply be defined as the cause or the relief of satisfaction.
Amen. A relief or a satisfaction. Yes. Anybody again with a yes, my brother.
It may also be consolation.
Consolation. Thank you very much. It will be also a consolation. So can you console somebody that is in the wedding? Is it possible to console somebody that is in the wedding? Huh? So that means there must be a situation that somebody must be in order for you to be consoled, isn't it? So in many cases, this situation used to be a very hard one. Not a happy one, but the one that can make you sad. So that means somebody that needs to be comforted is somebody that is in distress. Somebody that is feeling discomfort, somebody that is needs some encouragement, somebody that is going through tough times, in sickness, in sorrow, in pain, and a lot of unhappiness. So now, the Bible tells us that God, our God, is the source of all the comforts. So may we trust in Him when we find ourselves in situations that we don't understand.
Amen.
And because, as we can see in the Bible, even from the Bible, from the history of the Bible, there was a man that committed the first crime. Anybody who can remember his name? The first murder. The man that murdered first of all. Yes, brother. It was Cain. When you look at what Cain did, even in our time now, when you look at the people when they are murdering others, what comes to your mind? How do you feel about them? When people, they murder other people, do you used to be happy? But I have seen sometimes the men kill somebody, and then the police come and they arrest the men that killed someone. But you can see the people, they are shouting, no, don't take him, please. He deserves to die also. So, but even though Cain killed his brother, that was innocent, God didn't let him like that. He still put a protection upon him. He comforted him. And where the protection of God is, there is a great comfort there. So God put a mark on Cain as a protection, even though he made an innocent brother. But the grace of God was still upon him. May we find favor in the eyes of the Lord. So now we have to continue with our lesson. Can we open quickly to Genesis chapter 27? Genesis chapter 27. We are going to read from verse 41 to 46.
Verse 41. And Esau pleaded Jacob. And Esau pleaded Jacob because he blessed and loved his father and blessed him. And Esau said in his heart, if the days of mourning for my father are troubled, then will I slay my brother Jacob for me. And this word of Esau, I had a son who was told to Rebecca. And then she sent and called Jacob a younger son, and said unto him, behold, thy brother Esau has touched thee, thus comfort himself, purposing to kill thee. Now therefore, my son, be a man, arise, flee thou to Lebanon, go back to Aram, and tarry with him a few days, until thy brother's food turns away, until thy brother's hunger turns away from thee, and forget that which thou hast done to me. Then I will send and fetch thee from thence. Why should I be deprived also of you both in one day? Verses. And Rebecca said to Isaac, I am weary of my life because of the daughters of Heth. If Jacob takes the wife of the daughters of Heth, such as these which are of the daughters of the land, what good shall I be?
Amen. So, let's read it again, chapter 28, verse 1 and 2.
And Isaac called Jacob and blessed him and charged him and said unto him, thou shalt not take a wife of the daughters of Canaan. To arise, go to Padan Aram, to the house of Bethel, thy mother's father, and take thee a wife from hence for the daughters of Laban, thy mother's brother.
Amen. So, as we have said that we are going to discuss about comfort, today we are going to look in the life of one young man that was leaving his house, that was going at a place he never known before, the place he didn't really know much about, or to say he didn't know, he only used to hear about it since it was his family that was living there. So this man living at a very young age because of two things that was happening. So the first thing was something happened in their house. Their father called for the elder brother so that you come and he will bless him. And this young man, the mother called the young man and tell him what the father told the elder brother, what the elder brother was going. So then he come and tell the young brother, this is what I want you to do. Prepare something and give it to your father so that you go eat it, and then he will bless you. And this young man, by doing that made his brother very angry. And then now, this young man, his name is Jacob, he was supposed to fled his home. Now, imagine now, this young man was leaving his house, the house where he was raised, where he knew everything about his life. It was built, that short life that he lived, it was only in that place where he was. Now he had to leave it. How do you think maybe this young man was feeling in his heart? Have you ever left your place to go to another place you don't know? Yes, I believe some of you do. Yes.
Yeah, I left the place where I was going to train. Then why I was about to change the direction, I was afraid because that place I mean it, but the place I'm going, I don't know what's there. So I'm afraid of that or no place.
That's right. So now Jacob left his house. He take a journey to the unknown. And according to what we read now, maybe if you can, what was really the thing that made Jacob to move out of his place? Yes, brother. It's only brother Tayo. Or maybe my English is not that clear. Yeah, let my sister say this. Yes, my sister.
When Jacob was being persecuted by his brother, he came before he took the blessing instead of his elder brother.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And he found himself in the lonely place, the place that he don't know. It was a lot of things was happening to him in his journey. Number one, he was a very young boy. He didn't know where he was going. He didn't know the people he was going to. So all these things was going in his heart. And it was troubling him. And this man, the Bible says that he traveled for quite a distance, and then he came at the place, and he slept. So, according to our lesson, we read that when he slept, he had a dream. What did Jacob dream? Yes, my sister.
He had a dream that there was a ladder made up until heaven, and there were angels ascending and descending, and God was on top of him. So when he woke up, he knew that that was the place of God, and God was in him.
Amen. So imagine now, Jacob was in the wilderness where he was very afraid. Very afraid, and he walked for a long journey and he slept. And then at this place, when he slept, he dreamed of it. Now, when he dreamed, and as our sister said, that he dreamed of a ladder. The ladder where Hades was coming down, going up. Coming down, going up. And God was on top of this ladder. Now, imagine how much was he encouraged by this? Imagine you are in trouble. Okay? In deep trouble. And do you really used to think like when you are in trouble, sometimes? Do you really used to feel that God is with you? Not always. Many times you feel like, oh, there is nobody that is here with me now. I'm alone. God is not with me. But while Jacob was in this situation, he dreamed of a ladder. And when he saw a ladder, do you think that Jacob was encouraged more? He was very much encouraged. Very, very much encouraged. And by that time, because of what God did, because of what he said in the dream. Even though Jacob is the one who put himself in that journey, because if he could not betray his brother, he would not go there. God was there with him. Why was he with him? He was with him to comfort him. When we are in our troubles, when we are in our difficulties, God is there with us. Amen? Yes, sir.
And another thing is that before he would be in that situation, he must have been able to speak to God. Who could help? Who could deliver? Because say, what you are thinking and what the thought you have, he made you to dream out of the multitude of man. That is how you dream. See, if they are thinking of other things, if those people could have wanted to dream, then it's also things happening to people of you. God help me. God, now change everything for me, you know, because of this connection with God.
Amen. So that means Jacob, even though he was in this distress, he was still thinking about God. So when we find ourselves into trouble, let us not think about other things. When you become sick, don't think, oh, I'm just going to die and there's nothing more again. No, put it aside. That one, leave it. Don't think about it. When you don't have, you want to go to school, there is no money for you to go to school. Don't say, oh, I have no way to find money now, I just have to surrender everything. No, think about God all the time. And as Jacob was thinking about God, he dreamed of this dream. And I remember before I gave my life to Christ, the dreams I was used to be having. Very bad one. And I believe most of you also have got the same experience. So if you are still dreaming bad dreams, please commit yourself to God.
Amen.
And then he will change your dreams, as he changed for Jacob. Yes, Mama Edna, before you.
Thank you. For me, it's just
like
a patience. Like, sometimes we pray for the things that we want to create in our lives.
Mm-hmm.
And it's happened, especially because I believe that I experience, it's something that God, don't consider to God, or something, you couldn't hear me, are you there? But I don't know.
yesterday, you put to me and said, all your needs, all my human beings, I know. I know your trouble. I will attend to you. And I was so comforted. No matter how long time ago I prayed for, now I was like strengthened, as a strengthened by God. I told him, no matter if he didn't even do it, as long as I know that he healed me.
Amen. Amen. So, when you trust in God, He will reveal Himself to you. So, God revealed Himself to Jacob in order for him to encourage him. And that was a great encouragement. Do you know what God said when He revealed Himself to Jacob? Let's open quickly to chapter 28, verse 18. Let us read verse 18. Alone. Imagine if you are in distress, if you are in discomfort, if you are in sorrow, and then God, because of your trust in God, God revealed Himself to you and He said, I am the Lord God of Abraham, thy father, and the God of Isaac. The land whereon thou liest today will I give it, and to thy seed. Jacob did not know where he was going, but now God revealed Himself to him and He said, even the land where he was, God is going to give it to him. May God help us when we are in trouble that we may not panic.
Amen.
Because God is working out everything for our own good at the end of the day.
Yeah.
Amen? Amen? So, and this young man, when he hears this word from God, he says, wow, really? God is showing this place. And me, I did not know. It's not every situation that you are going through that you will be understanding. But when you trust God who understands everything, believe me, you will be too much encouraged. And for your good at the end of the day, you will stand strong. So, Jacob becomes so much encouraged by what God did when He revealed Himself to him. And Jacob makes a promise to God. God cannot reveal Himself to you for nothing. Are we together? God cannot reveal Himself to you for nothing. When God reveals Himself to you, it's for the purpose that you make an extra effort to be of more than what you have been before. Amen? So Jacob, he said in verse 21, he made promises to God. And we start chapter 28, we are going to start with verse 20. And Jacob called a vow, saying, if God will be with me and will keep me in this way, that I go and will give me bread to eat and raiment to put on. Verse 21, so that I come again to my father's house in peace, then shall the Lord be my God. Jacob personalized God for himself. Jacob chose God to be his God. May we choose God to be our God.
Amen?
Amen? It is very, very important. And this is the time now that God promised. He said so many good things to Jacob. The one He said to Abraham, I will multiply you. I will bless you. Everybody will be blessed. You are going to be the father of many, many nations. So God has planted so much in you that at the end of the day, He's waiting to harvest. And it's our responsibility that we do what God has given us. And at the end of the day, it will be for the glorification of God. So there are times in our life where we find ourselves feeling like, oh, I don't know what to do. Times that you can say, if it could not be for God, I don't know what could happen. If it could not be God, I could not go that through. Is there somebody with a small and short testimony that you can just share with us that, no, I was going through this and because of God, He comforted me. Is there somebody who could just a short testimony about comfort? God did not do anything for anybody here. What did God do for you? You were so much distressed. And God helped you out. Yes, my sister.
Being so faithful.
I find myself in difficult situations. I think about my life, about the past, and how God has helped me. Sometimes I just find myself crying over things that have been happening to me. And when I pray, God just reminds me that I've always been with you.
Amen.
There was a time I was in Angola, and it was the rainy season,
mm-hmm.
and the house, God is going to be praying. Mm-hmm. And I was inside the house and I was alone. And I said, God, I know that you want me to grow up and you want me to fulfill your purpose.
Mm-hmm.
I know you've created me for something in this life. So today just save me from this wreck. I must not die inside this house.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know how it happened. All the things just fall inside,
mm-hmm.
but I was fine. When people came, they were asking, how did you survive inside this thing like that? And I was saying, it's just God. I don't know how.
Amen. We thank God. And there are so many people that have got sad testimonies. Whereby they don't know what to do, but God come, stretch out his hand, and he rescued them. That's a great comfort. We thank God for that. So, in every situation that you find yourself in, I'm not saying every situation that you'll be going through is God who allow you to come. There are situations that you cause them yourself. You understand? You cause them yourself and you have to suffer the consequences. Everything that we did, we have to suffer the consequences. Is it? The good one, we get the blessing, but the bad one, we suffer the consequences. But in everything, trust God to work out the good thing. In everything, he will do it. So, for this encouragement, you can just open quickly to 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. Quickly, because of our time. 1 Thessalonians
chapter
5, verse 18.
In everything, be careful, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning.
In how many things?
Everything.
So, and when I was reading the Bible, there was this scripture that I wanted to share with you, but it's too long. Only because of time, we have to continue. So, in the book of Acts, Paul and Silas, they were preaching the word of God somewhere. Sharing the word of God. Everything was going well. But at the end of the day, the people from that place, they were so jealous of them. And they decided, no, these guys cannot go on like this. They deliver a certain lady that was making money for some people. Then they say, no, these guys, they are making commotion, they are disturbing the people. So they reported to the authorities, and then the authority, they came. They was arrested. And you know one thing that happened to them? They didn't do anything wrong. They were just... Is it wrong to deliver someone? It is not wrong. It's a very good thing for somebody who was in prison and then they deliver him from that. So, sharing the word of God is not a bad thing. It's a good thing because the word of God is bringing salvation. And because of this, they was jailed. And they was beaten very bad. And thrown in prison. So, when they was in prison, Paul and Silas did not sit back and say, oh, okay, maybe God now is not here with us. He don't know what to do. Why is he going to protect us from us? No! They stood up and praised God. They choose God to be their power and their comfort. May we do the same when we find ourselves in a situation where we don't understand.
Amen. It's for our own good, because when we trust God, it will protect us from distress. It will protect us from all the fear. So, these people, Paul and Silas, they praise and worship God. And at the end, it was salvation to the fellow jailer and also to the one that was looking after the prison. Sometimes your difficulty, sometimes your uncertainty is for a reason, in order for somebody to be saved. Amen?
Amen.
So, trusting God is the right thing. So, now, for us to be assured of God's comfort, there are some situations, okay? There are conditions that we need to be in. So I want us to read some verses just quickly, and then you become. Which one? What are we supposed to have according to that verse in order for us to be able to get
the comfort of God. Genesis chapter 28, verse 7. Chapter 28, verse 7. Quickly.
And that Jacob obeyed his father and his mother and was going to his father's
land. What character Jacob was having? Yes, my brother. Oh, obedience. Yes, obedience. Chapter 28, verse 22, quickly. Verse 22.
And this stone which I have set for you, for Peter, shall be God's house, and of all that thou shalt give me, I will surely give
them. Amen. Anybody pick something up? What character Jacob was having? Yes, my sister. He was thanking. Very well. 31 verse 18. Chapter 31 verse 18, quickly. Chapter 31 verse 18. Good. Jacob heard this word from God, and then because of that, he obeyed. So there was a communication between God and Jacob. And at the end of the day, Jacob did what God told him. And as we can continue, Jacob was diligent at service when he was working with his father. He didn't steal anything. He was not unfaithful. Always he was on time. He could do all that he wanted. And he was ready to pay the price. Do you remember when the father of, I believe we have read the story, the father of Rachel and Leah, his father-in-law, when he came to him and he asked him, what do you want me to pay you for? What did Jacob say? The father-in-law asked the price that Jacob had to get for selling him. What did Jacob say? Nobody read it. So Jacob, he said, no, I can work for you 7 years to give me your daughter. 7 years so that you can get a daughter to marry. I don't know if they're good. My brother, will you be willing to work for 7 years to get a wife? It's not easy for a wife, 7 years working only for a wife to be given at the end of the 7 years. So Jacob was not a lazy man. He decided to work. So and he worked. At the end of the first 7 years, did he get the wife he was looking for? No, it was chased. He got another wife. Then he said, anyway. But we thank God, he continued. Even in this time, God was still with him. So, at the end of the day, he went again for another 7 years. And he went for 14 years to get Leah. That is what love can do. Do you understand? So imagine and all this there was on the account of Rachel. He went for Rachel first for 7 years. It was changed. Then he again went for another 7 years. And together it was 14. So we thank God. God gave him the strength. And at the end of the day, he got his two wives. I'm not saying go and marry to wait for 14 years so that you can get two wives. No. Now the dispensation has changed. We are now on the grace whereby everybody, one man, one woman. So we thank God that at the end of the day, all went well. Let's open quickly to chapter 31, verse 38 and 39. Amen. So sometimes when a person you are working somewhere, you feel like, anyway, this is my boss. So you find this tea there. You start making tea, drinking, put a lot of sugar in your cup because it's for your boss. Anyway, I'm also working here. Is that faithfulness? When you are doing things what you are not supposed to do, is that a good picture to your boss or to your parents? Anyway, my mother, she don't like me to use sugar when she's at home, so now I'm using when she's not there. Is that a good thing to do? So Jacob, in all that he did, he was a very faithful man. That's why for the 20 years, he had been with the animals for his father-in-law. Even the one that was eaten by animals, it's not him who stole them or made them lost. But he decided to pay them back. Faithfulness. Faithfulness is needed from us. Please, don't wait for somebody to deceive you, then it's the time that you want to be a faithful person. Be faithful when nobody sees you, because God is watching. Amen? And when you are faithful, sometimes you can be feeling like, oh, I'm always faithful and nobody recognizes it. But God is there. He's waiting for the right time. When you are going to be in trouble, when you are going to be there, he will be there to comfort you. Believe me, you don't know how many things Jacob has went through because of his father-in-law. But still, he stands and waits upon God. And at the end of the day, God comes to his rescue. So may God help us that we may trust him. So at the end of the day, Jacob, the man of God, longed to go back home. And on his way, himself as a person, as a man, as a human being, there were a lot of things that was happening in his mind. But God was on his side. With all the instruction God was giving him in the when he was with his father-in-law, as Bible students, we read the Bible most of the time or many times. When the father-in-law of Jacob agreed with him about the animal, they agreed that no, all the animals that are fed, they are mine. The ones that are fed, they are yours. Okay? And then God gave Jacob a strategy. Is there somebody who read it? What strategy did God give to him in order for his animal to be different from the one of his father-in-law? Nobody read it. Yes, my sister. He is a so the animal for Jacob was having spots. Yes, thank you, my sister. But God tell Jacob to do something. Anybody read it? God said, no, Jacob, it is. When the animals are coming to drink, all those that are pregnant, we were supposed to put something in the water, and all the animals that are pregnant are going to give the spotted animals, they are going to give it to the spotted animal, small one. The one that Jacob and his father-in-law agreed. And the day, the strategy of God worked. And the family of Jacob's father-in-law, they was like, what? Even the children, his wives, they was like, no. This man is stealing the animal for our father. Because all the animals was giving this birth to spotted animals. And Jacob became a very rich man. Why? Because of his obedience. Because of his faithfulness. Because he was a tithing man. And he was always having a communication with God. May we possess such characters. And at the end of the day, God is going to be with us. So, let's read quickly to chapter 13. We're going to read verses 25 to 30. Chapter 13, 25 to 30. Quickly.
That Jacob said to my brother, send me away, that I may go into my own place and to my country. Give me my wives and my children for whom I have served thee, and let me go, for thou knowest my service which I have done thee. 27 And Laban said unto me, I pray thee, if I have found favor in thy eyes, tell me, for I have learned by experience that the Lord hath blessed thee for thy sake. 28 And he said, appoint me thy wages, and I will be thy. And he said unto me, thou knowest how I have served thee, and how thy little was in heaven. For it was little which thou hadst before I came, and it is now increased unto the multitude, and the Lord has blessed this thing for thee. And now, when shall I provide for my own house also?
31. Oh, only up to 30. Thank you, my sister. So, the time came for Jacob when he started to miss his house, where he came from. And God again came and gave him a strategy to leave the how he had to go. But rather his father-in-law, he was not satisfied. He said, no, please, can I, if I find favor in your eyes, can I stay? Can you stay again with me? And he said, no, it's time to go. Because God had said, I have to go. Remember, there was a good connection between Jacob and God. Amen? So may God, when he tell us something, may we obey without question. And just obey and follow the instruction. Whether it seems like, I don't know now. Just obey and follow the instruction. Do as God said. And at the end of the day, you'll be a blessed man. So, Jacob, even though when he came from home, he betrayed his father. This thing didn't bother him now yet. He decided to go. So then, he went out. When he went out, one of his wives steal the idol for his father. And when they was walking, going in their way, the father-in-law came. He followed them. Pursued them. While he was pursuing them, God intervened. And they say, Laban, be careful. Be careful. Leave that man. That man is a very obedient man. He's a faithful man. He's a tithing man. He's somebody that cares about. He's somebody that always knows about him. So, when you are trusting in God, he will come to your aid. So, God warned Laban not to do anything bad to Jacob. And we thank God, Laban obeyed. Now, the time came when now the danger started. He started to think, I can understand now. Oh, my brother, he's still at home now, where I'm going. He started to remember all the things that he had done in the past. My goodness, what am I doing? So he started to plan. a man that God just defended just a few days ago, a few minutes ago. Fear Moses. And he started to use human strategy. He started to make plans. How am I going to please my brother? How am I going to tell my brother to come? How am I going to approach him? What am I going to do? And then he tried the first one. He said words to his brother. Tell my brother, let's look at it. Chapter 32, verse 4. Chapter 32, verse 4. He said the word to his brother. Chapter 32, verse 4. Who can read it for us? So he didn't contact God. He did his own action. This plan did not succeed. Whenever you take your own plan, whenever you try to maneuver your way, it will not work out. May God help us that we will always trust God. And even in our way that we cannot see if there is a way through, may we learn to trust in God. So this way for Jacob did not work out. And he decided to take another strategy. Jacob started to panic. Danger was everywhere. He couldn't take it by himself. Then at the end of the day, he decided, there is something that I need to do. There is something that I need to do. I can't go on like this. Please. And then he decided to separate himself from everyone. And this is a sign of consecration. Until we set ourselves apart from God. And at the end, God came. And he became very strong. Yes, he battled with the angel. How long did they battle? How did Jacob fight with the angel? When Jacob was found, yes, my man. Till daybreak, for the whole night. So he consecrated himself for a very long time. May we consecrate ourselves for a very long time, and God will help us. So Jacob, at the end of the day, he was strengthened, he was encouraged, he was comforted by God, and he faced his brother. When he faced his brother, when it was time now to meet his brother, he was sending other people to go ahead. And then at the end, when God met him, he was the one that went in front. May God strengthen you. When trouble comes, that will be the one that will be leading everybody else. Because of our time, please, when you find yourself in a situation you don't understand, God understands. When you find yourself you will not know what to do, God knows what to do. It is our responsibility that we stand. It is our duty that we choose Him. There is a great example of a man that trusted in God. And this man was Job. Job trusted in God. And at the end of the day, can we just read it quickly, please? Job chapter 23, verse 8 and 12. Job chapter 23, verse 8 and 12. 8 to 12, quickly. Job? Yes.
On the left hand, we are industrial, but I cannot be good.
The handwriting itself on the writer that I cannot see. But he knew the way that I did. When he has tried me, my comfort has good. My foot has helped his steps. His way about it and not the man. For neither have I gone back from the mountain of his feet. And esteem the word of his mouth more than I'm necessary to.
Amen. So, when you find yourself in the situation that you don't know, this is the encouragement from Job. Job is the man that was very sick. And even his wife advised him and said, "Why? What are you waiting for? Just swear God and then you die." Job will say, "Hey, that's not a good advice." Sometimes you find yourself in the situation whereby even your friends are telling you, "Ah, you are done. You are finished. There's nothing for you again." Trust God. Trust God, he will come to your rescue. Amen. So God was the strength of Job. And he will be your strength when you trust in him. It was not automatic. It's because Job trusted in him. And God made it his mission to make sure that Job is strengthened, comforted, and encouraged. And at the end of the day, Job stand victorious. So your trials are just there for temporary. They didn't come to destroy you, okay, but to help you to move on. There was a woman with the issue of blood in Matthew chapter 9, verse 22. So Jesus said to her, "Be of good cheer, thy faith has made thee whole." When we have faith in God, he will come to our aid. He will help us. He will encourage us. He will comfort us. May God help us that we may stand in faith, even when it seems to be impossible. So, this is the end of our lesson.